How cell phones were a lifeline for students, but in our area, they may not actually work in an emergency. It didn't for one student trying to call 911.
One friend of mine, he was hurt, and I couldn't help him because I didn't have good reception.
Camorris Peterson learned the hard way that his cell phone service was spotty while at school.
So I had to run down to the middle of the hallway just to call the ambulance.
A fellow student at Suncoast Community High hurt his leg and needed someone to call for help.
Certain areas, like say down the hall, towards the end of the building is really bad. But then once you get towards like the middle, it's really good.
So you have to walk to a different location to get better coverage?
Yeah.
There's a massive, massive problem. And if you of people that think they have coverage or should have coverage and don't.
Jeff Cohn runs the website deadcellzones.com. For years, he's collected thousands of complaints about cell phone dead zones across the country. On the map, wireless customers drop pins where they've suddenly lost service. Using the map, CBS 12 News investigates found 9 schools in Palm Beach County with reported dead zones less than 1 mile away, including several T-Mobile dead zones near Congress Middle and Boynton Beach High, a Verizon dead zone near Jupiter High, an AT&T dead zone near Palm Beach Gardens High, and a Sprint dead zone near Suncoast. Cohn says schools are a common place to lose signals because of their construction.
If you have a lot of cinder block walls, or if you have a lot of steel in the building, that can hinder signals from the outside working inside a classroom.
We took it a step further and asked parents and students to do their own test outside of class hours. One T-Mobile user at Royal Palm Beach Community High tried to call his mother from inside the school and took this screenshot showing the call failed. Another student using Sprint tried to call from South Fork High in Martin County, but her call failed too. We asked school districts what they're doing about the problem of cell phone dead zones. Palm Beach School says if there are dead zones, students and staff can connect to Wi-Fi to call or text. But St. Lucie Schools is doing more.
We've been a very proactive school district. We have multiple boxes because you have multiple cables that are being run throughout the building.
They've installed pervasive Wi-Fi and these cell phone repeaters in several buildings to boost the signal.
That could run anywhere from $10,000 for a device to $20,000 for a single device.
Chief Operating Officer Terrence O'Leary says repeaters help cell phone towers penetrate these walls built to withstand hurricanes.
And they're not cheap. So we are working on that and planning through that proactively, but that requires funding.
Hoping to strengthen the signal with more grant money or state funding, because the ability to communicate during an emergency is priceless. Martin County and Indian River schools say they're not aware of any issues. Okeechobee Schools says there are dead zones in several but not all buildings, but they would not reveal where due to security concerns, adding that they are installing equipment to address the issue. Danielle Waugh, CBS 12 News, investigate.